It's been crazy. Like, I realize how little I've been doing this week. It's just been, it's good to be back. You know, I'm doing similar stuff that I've done before, but it's just good to see everyone jumping around all the different cities, playing different places, playing acoustic sets with the band, and yeah, just doing the rounds. It's good to be back. I've missed it. I finished the tour last year and I felt really pumped up about the next project and kind of didn't really stop. I just kind of went home, took a couple of weeks off just because that's what you're meant to do, I suppose. And then probably should have taken longer, but I got too excited and started writing loads of songs. And it, you know, I had a good year because I didn't really stick a timeline on anything. So I was writing whilst enjoying my summer, you know, going to festivals, playing sports, etc. So I was living kind of a relatively, you know, normal life, and studio was, you know, part of that. I mean, and it's been really fun, but as I say, it's just good to be releasing music again and ready to go. I showed it off in places on my last album, The Rockier Side, in a couple of tunes, and Slow Hands obviously leans into that 80s kind of rock pop type thing. So I just wanted to take a step, like the whole idea is every time you do something is just to take everything to the next level, and I think this single and the whole record kind of really just another just step forward, and doesn't feel too crazy like that to the point where it would scare people off, but it's definitely just kind of just taking the next step up and yeah, just make a bit of a move, yeah. I've obviously been rehearsing the song. It was just an acoustic version that we've been working on, which sounds really cool. And we've been working on it just in the rehearsal room, just me, myself and the band, and we're really the only ones that have heard it. So that was the first time I played last night to like 200 of, you know, the hardcore fans, and it was wild in there. I could barely, like, I had really good sound in that room last night in my inner monitors, but didn't hear a thing. I was just playing along to what I thought I could hear the drummer playing the beat, and they were just singing every word. They were really pumped up about it, knew every word, screaming it out. It is one of those songs though, it kind of gets you going every time you hear it, and it makes you want to just sing along to it. But to see the fan reaction in front of me was that was pretty cool. Yeah, I just wanted to do it, you know, because they've been waiting for so long, and I'm not going to probably release the album till maybe February or March next year. So I thought to myself, let's give them something at least, you know, and just throw them in different places. Some were seen, some things make more sense when you hear other songs in the record, like the Angel Wings on the back of Georgia, on George's back. And the fact that it was raining and snowing and sunshine and all in one. Guess so. Kind of tied in on that kind of narrative, and yeah, it all comes together. But I just wanted to do it. I just wanted to drop in some bits and pieces, little Easter eggs that they could enjoy while they wait around for me again. Yeah, I had loads of songs that I really liked. I've actually what we call like a high class problem, where I'm like nearly struggling to whittle down, you know, exactly how many songs are going to be on the record, because I like so many of them. Which is I'm not saying they're all smashes, but like I just like them. A lot of the time you have some songs and you don't really like them at all, but I really like all of them, so I'm struggling to get it down. But this one just like it just stands out. Like I like a song. I like my attention, you know, to be got straight away the minute a song comes in. Like I like a good intro or a good start to a song. So I feel like this just gets your ears perked up a little bit when it comes on just straight away. And it just, as I said, as we've been saying, that it's, you know, it's been nearly 2 years since I released a song. So if you're gonna, as I've been saying as well, you know, if you're gonna come back, make some noise and come back with a splash. It was the first thing that I wrote down, you know, the whole idea of kind of the different types of days that you have when you break up with. It's not all like sitting around being sad. You have some days where you're like rebellious and you want to go and, you know, go out in town and paint the town red type stuff, and then you literally just have days where you do sit there and write sad songs and feel sorry for yourself and eat chocolate and stuff like that. Yeah, literally watch the, you know, you do have that, but you also have the other side of it. So I wanted different, some songs are tied together, some songs are written from the opposite person's point of view. Yeah, and just like something that, as you say, as you've been saying, that represents all the different aspects of a breakup. And I like the idea of it, instead of just being a typical breakup album where every song is about the same thing. But I just kind of wanted to change things up. It's kind of like more the raw, like what the lyric says and the feel that you get off your first day. Like when I wrote Nice to Meet You, all I had was and that's the, that was the main thing I had. And then one of the guys goes and sits, I start singing, I like the way you talk, whatever, and then someone's playing the piano in the background and it starts to build into something as you go. But I tend to just sit there and write the song on a piano or an acoustic guitar, and you just have a feeling by just what the way you're playing, you know, the rhythm, the, you know, the groove that you've got going on, you can just tell where it would like to lean towards. But there has been songs where, there's a song on the record coming up, I haven't mentioned the name of it, but it was a piano ballad, and I just felt like in my head, actually when I release it, I'll probably just release it with, like, that show the fans what was like, to give you an idea of what can happen in that process. Because I was here, it was like really slow and just four chord ballad, and then I was hearing like kind of teenage dream type vibes, or that kind of stuff, and I could hear it in the songwriting. And it's kind of like when Katy Perry would sit down with a guitar and play a Teenage Dream, you know, it makes sense as an acoustic song, and it also makes sense as a big tune. So I kind of heard that in it, and yeah, it's just crazy what can happen in that period.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe for more videos from your favorite artist. And while you're here, check out these other videos.